What I have here is a really straightforward branching scenario built in Twine. This story has 27 different outcomes. When we look at it, it's got the default formatting. These visuals are quite boring. It's not very accessible. The links are a little bit dark. So we're going to edit the CSS to change these visuals. To do that, we'd come into story, and then style sheet here refers to CSS. If we're just looking at the appearance, this will do. Let me go ahead, before I write any code here, let's look at how we're referring to some of these elements. If we test it out, you can see the document object model. This view lets us know what we should call things when we're programming it. So for example, this whole panel looks like it's tw-passage, twine passage. The whole page is twine story. Cool, that's really helpful. So let's start off by changing the background. All right, that would be it. All I need to do is plug in the URL. I got this from Unsplash. Let's test it out. Hey, now I'm noticing the font and the colors, still don't love those. So let's target those next. Let's go ahead, we can change it right in this same passage here. Font family. Let's go with something pretty basic for this project. And the color, I'm gonna use a hex code for these because you can customize them a bit more. Gonna go for sort of a vintage looking rust color. And there we have it. Notice the links didn't change. That's because we still need to add directions for those. They have two different colors. There's a link color and a hover color. So let's add those. All right, let's see if those links and link hover states have changed. Test it out. There we go. That looks nicer. Okay. So last thing, I feel like this still isn't that easy to read because it's on the background. I want a little white box to show up behind the text. So for that, we actually aren't going to use CSS. If you go into any of your individual passages here, you'll see it's actually an option under the color panel. You can change the background for it. It uses the Harlow built-in syntax. I want to show you some of the language built into the program so you can edit visuals another way. It needs to go at the start of all this. Delete the default text. Okay, let's test it out. There we go. All right, bear with me for a minute while I add this macro onto all the different outcomes. All right, so testing it, that looks a little bit better. I will say one thing that I still don't love about it is now that we have this white box in the background, the text runs right up to the edge of it. There's no padding at all. So I am going to add some padding. Let's try this. So on our style sheet, these are called passages. I'm gonna add some padding there. Let's start with 30 pixels, see if that looks good. Hey, much better. And that's how you would add CSS to your different stories in Twine.